We're back at it again this morning. We got Steve running the roller today, so hopefully I got all this muck, which there's still a little bit, there's more groundwater coming in, but and I need to get the pump fired back up. I got me a little holding tank back there for the excess water, but I'm trying to get this in my more of like a 8 to 10 inch lift range instead of how thick we've been putting it. So hopefully we got a little better system down. I got someone here running the roller today, and I got a little more time between the trucks and kind of had a little meeting with them and told them if I'm not 100% ready, just to wait. I get it knocked down and then I'll get them backed up to where I'm sitting at, so maybe things will go a little smoother. We're just gonna keep on doing this and making our way around here.
Thank you.
doing pretty good today. I got a pretty good system down now. I was able to finally start putting this stuff in like 8 to 10 inch lifts. So it's actually helping compact it a whole lot better. And I got Steve, he's on the roller just running up and down. And then I think I've only got 3 trucks running right now, which isn't too bad. I can keep up with them pretty easy. But we are, I don't know, we may be 3/4 of the way around, because I still got a bunch of mud and stuff to kind of skim out there. But down where that pine's at is where it starts to curve, or the big radius where we stopped yesterday. And then I got to finish pumping that water out, or Billy may be working on that, so I got to get that muck out of there, but then we can kind of keep going. So I'm just kind of doing an 8 or 10 inch lift, letting Steve roll it and let those trucks just keep running over it. And then we'll either eventually just keep going like this, or I'll let Steve work on this down here, and then I'll just kind of start up there and do another lift or whatever. But I'm trying to just let him drive on it and run on as much. I haven't really filmed a ton of it because kind of after you see him dump a load or two and me knock it down, you can just repeat that process about 500 times. So I'll just try to kind of update you guys as we go. But yeah, hopefully by the end of the day, I'll either be all the way around there, or we'll put another couple lifts or whatever in here. But this is working out pretty well so far. Nope, looks like there's another truck there, so we'll get him back down here and get this knocked down. I got it up to the existing grade all the way to here. And you can see back there, that's where I got to quit. All my mud and my water and stuff still there. So I got that pump running, and then it's probably going to take 10 or 15 loads to fill that little spot in. But I'm going to try to get it to there and then get the excavator and dig all that out and try to shove that in there tomorrow. I don't know what... We've got to be over 500 loads or whatever now. They didn't give me a count the last 2 days. We've been short on trucks. Yes, I guess it was yesterday, and the day before we only had 3. And then this morning I had 2. And then it got down to 1 because one of the trucks had to leave. So luckily Dad was coming down here anyway with his dumb truck to move some dirt. So now I got him running his truck along with one of the other ones. So I'm just going to have 2 for today. So I'm hoping I can get to that end and get that done. And then I think we're going to concentrate on cleaning all the spoils and junk up along the sides. And then we'll go back and do one more lift, I guess, because they really wanted about 6 to 8 inches above the existing grade on the sides, which is what it needs to be. So that'll be like another 125 loads to put in here, I think. But the guys hauling the clay got to go work on some other jobs next week, and that'll give us some time, like I said, to clean some of this mud and junk up. And that way, if we do get it on here, we can skin it off and then throw more of the clay. And then we'll let it settle for a bit, and then right before the guys come to start on the train track, I guess we'll come out here like a week or so ahead. We're going to lay fabric over this whole thing once we get it up to the grade we need to be, and then bring in base rock. I think we're going to put 6 inches of base rock all across the whole thing. And then on the side that the track's going to be, they'll set the ties and the tracks, and then we'll come back and do, I guess it's like the railroad ballast or the clean rock or whatever around it. And the road will just have the 6 inches of base rock on top of there. So
this is where we made it to today. Probably, I don't know, 75 feet, 65 feet from the end down here. So yeah, just having the 2 trucks took a little while to get down here.